Today I'm going to be doing a question and answer. I was like, well, what is this called? I'm going to be doing a question and answer video for you guys today, and I'm super excited to be doing this because I realized yesterday I have not done a Q&A on my channel. I'm like looking it up right now on YouTube. Hold on. It's been over a year since I've done a Q&A, which is way too long. I think I only had like 100,000 subscribers or something when I did my last Q&A. That's actually the only one I've ever done. So today's Q&A is going to be a little bit more of a personal one. Tons of you guys were asking me personal questions about my life and my family and that kind of stuff. So that's what today is gonna be. And then I figured in a couple of weeks, maybe like a month or so from now, we can do a makeup Q&A where it's just strictly makeup based. You guys can ask me advice or whatever it is that's going on, you guys can ask me. So I thought that that would kind of make sense. You know what I'm saying? That way this can be personal, the next one can be makeup. Does that make sense? Let me know how you feel about that. And then I also thought, because so many of you have been asking to like hear my story, if you will, of how I became, you know, a makeup artist in general, or got a job at MAC, or, you know, fell into the industry, whatever it may be. So I'm kind of thinking of making an entire video just kind of how I got started as a makeup artist in the industry, what I did, kind of tips that can maybe help you guys. If you guys want to see a full dedicated video to that, let me know in the comments down below. Tweet me, whatever it is, just let me know somehow through some outlet, and I will totally make a video on that as well. So today is gonna be a question and answer. I have screenshotted so many questions on Twitter. Oh my gosh, it's insane. But it's funny because a lot of the questions are very similar. Like, for the most part, everyone almost asks the same questions, just worded differently. So I'm kind of gonna take like the really popular ones and hit those. Got you. The number one question, oh my God, that I got tweeted about, I got hundreds of you guys asking me this, is when and if John and I are planning on having children. So to answer that question, I have talked about this before, and so if you've been around for a long time, you're gonna know the answer to this. I do not have the desire to have children. I love children, I love babies so much, and every time I see a baby or I smell a baby, listen, don't judge me, okay? Or I hold a baby, I'm like, oh my God! And I do have four nieces and nephews in my family, and the youngest of them right now is 4 years old. So the babies are gone, and it kind of sucks because I'm so used to having infants and babies around in my family, and I'm like, wait, I want another baby to hang out with, but I'm not ready for my own. Like, I'm only 24 years old. Everyone thinks I'm older than that. I'm only 24. John is 3 years older than me, and I'm not there. And honestly, I don't feel the pressure from the world to have kids. Like, I feel like everyone is trying to put on me. When John and I got married, it was like, everyone's like, so when are you having kids? And we're like, hello, look at our lives. Like, we can't even afford rent. You think we're gonna have a baby right now? Like, that's responsible. What is your biggest pet peeve? Oh gosh, let me think. What is my biggest pet peeve? If you would have asked me this 4 years ago, I would say bra straps. I know that's so random, but like, if a shirt like this, if you're wearing it and you're wearing a normal bra and you can see your bra straps, that still kind of drives me crazy, but not as much as it used to. It used to be like it would just like pick at my skin. Now I would have to say being late, or if someone else makes me late. Oh, like if I'm ready and on time and someone that I'm like going somewhere with, they're driving and they're late picking me up, I'm just in the car like I can't stand being late. I'm very punctual, so I have to say that's like my number one pet peeve. What shows are you currently watching on Netflix? Hello, Friends has been on repeat, repeat, repeat since January 1st, of course. I mean, I've watched the show like pretty much every week to every month since the show ended like 10 years ago, but since it's on Netflix now, it's so easy. I don't have to like change out DVDs. So it's like on my TV constantly. I'm not gonna lie, it was on this computer 5 seconds before I started recording. So Friends, all the time. What age did you start wearing makeup? Well, I mean, like, I don't really know what exact age I would put on that, because I've worn makeup since I was like a wee little tot. Knee-high to a pig's thigh. I have worn makeup because my sister is 7 years older than me, and my mom, she's always been like a glamazon. So I've always played with makeup and always worn makeup, but my mom really let me express myself at a young age. Like, I have pictures of like a family Christmas card where I'm wearing dark purple lipstick and I'm like 7 or 8 years old. Like, my mom was just like, just let her do her thing. So I don't know how she did that, because I feel like if I had a daughter, I'd be like, you are not leaving the house looking like that. But my mom let me make a fool out of myself all the time. So I can't think of like an exact age. Will you be launching your own makeup line soon? I just don't know. Netflix or shopping? Both. I'm not a big shopper, like going out shopping, I'm not that big. I prefer online shopping anyway, so like, hello, best of both worlds. Well, actually best of all worlds, Netflix, shopping, pajama pants or no pants, and ice cream. Like, I'm sorry, but life doesn't get better than that. Do you think you would survive a zombie apocalypse? Hell yes. I so think I could survive a zombie apocalypse. Like, I watch these movies and I'm like, is everyone an idiot? Like, I'm already high strung. I'm already anxiety ridden. And so if anything bad happens, like, my adrenaline kicks in and I'm like, ooh, ooh. Like, I swear, I'm like that woman who, like, flips a car when my adrenaline takes over. So I totally think that I could survive for sure. I'd be saving all my friends and family. My brother would survive too. He's totally a survivor. You go, Glenn Coco. When you were younger, what was your dream job? Hello, to be Britney Spears. What would you be doing if you never discovered YouTube? I would be doing the exact same thing that I'm doing right now, just not on YouTube. When I started YouTube, I was on my fourth year at MAC Cosmetics, and I was currently a product specialist with the company. So I was moving upward, you know, and my freelance business had just started getting much busier as, you know, YouTube started becoming something. And at that time, I thought, like, that's what I was gonna do with my life. I wanted to start my own business in the Tampa Bay area. I wanted to hire employees. I wanted to rent out a space. Like, that's what I wanted at that moment. But then God had other plans for me, and that never happened, but I am so blessed that my life did go a different direction, but that was my plan. And if YouTube were to shut down today, that's exactly what I would do. How do you and John work through fights if you have them? Okay, I love that she says, if you have them. No, we don't fight ever. Like, we just wake up in the morning and it's hugs and kisses and rainbows all day, and we just look at each other and we smile. No, yes, John and I definitely fight. I pretty much scream until he sees my side and then we move on. I'm just kidding. What's the cutest thing that John does or has done for you? Oh my God, I know. When we were first married, I was sick with I had a stomach flu and I had a really bad head cold, and I was laying in bed like miserable. And I was like, I need more cold medicine. So he's like, okay, let me go get it for you. So he goes to the kitchen, and a few minutes later, all of a sudden I hear like, and I'm like, what is that? And I look over the side of my bed and he has like one of his remote control cars, and it's like banging up against the bed. And I'm like, what? Yes, my husband has remote control cars. Listen, he's a little boy at heart. I love him for it. It is what it is. And I'm like, oh my God, what is this? And I look down, and on top of the remote control car is the DayQuil medicine and then a little note. And I'm like, stop. And I pick it up, and the note was so cute. It was like such a quick note that he had written, but it was just like a sweet little love note. And I look around the corner and I can like barely see his head, and he's like looking at the remote, like looking at the car, like controlling it. And I was like, oh my God, I love you. He's a cutie. How old were you and your husband when you guys met? I was 15. I had just turned 15, and John was probably just about to turn 18 when we just met. That's not when we started dating. We knew each other for years before we started dating. I had a boyfriend when we met, and he had a girlfriend, and he came over to my house with one of his friends, and I was laying on my couch watching Willy Wonka, and he walked in, and I was like, who the hell is this up in my house? Hello, let me get a mirror. What is your favorite restaurant in Tampa? Oh, I love food so much, so I have so many favorite restaurants, but I would have to say Dats. If you guys come to the Tampa area, go to Dats. It's always, always busy, no matter what day, what time of day you go. But it's a great Tampa restaurant, and it's just like, it's Tampa. You know, it's in the middle, it's in the heart of South Tampa, and it's just a good Tampa restaurant. Oh, it's so yummy, and their Bloody Marys are so good, and I hate Bloody Marys, but they have bacon in theirs, so. What motivates you to be such a positive person? I don't like myself when I'm negative. Like, if I'm just having a negative day, like, some days I'll wake up and just be like, oh, I feel like crap, I didn't get enough sleep, blah, 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 and I'll just find myself complaining all day. At the end of that day, I feel exhausted, and I just feel gross and just like dirty, like, ugh. I need to go like look at myself in the mirror and force myself to smile, because you just don't feel good when you're being negative. So that's honestly my motivation, is I just want to feel good. I want to be happy, so I'm gonna smile and I'm gonna dance until I feel happy. Do you ever drink alcohol? I've never seen you post about clubs or bars or wine or anything. I'm just curious. A lot of you guys actually ask me this question, if I go clubbing, if I drink, that kind of thing. And I don't go clubbing. I haven't been to a club since I was 19. Yeah. And even then I didn't drink because I was 19. But no, I'm not like a party girl. And it's funny because everyone thinks I am. When everyone meets me, they're like, hey, let's go to the club. And I'm like, let's go to the couch. If I have a night off, I'll sit on the couch and catch up on my shows and drink a glass of wine. You know what I'm saying? I'm telling you, I get the old lady award for YouTube, right? What are your best coping methods for anxiety? And then she said, so proud of you for putting yourself out there. Aw, that's so sweet. Yes, I have anxiety. I don't talk about it that often because, like, who wants to talk about their anxiety and their problems? If you have anxiety, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Yeah, I have anxiety big time. And I've gone through therapy for it, and I've done like natural remedies for it, and I've done a lot for my anxiety. It's a lot better than it used to be. I used to struggle with very severe panic attacks, which were horrible. They were crippling. I wasn't like able to do anything in life because I would panic so hard. But my best coping methods for anxiety, honestly, like this is something I learned about a year ago, is if I will start to have anxiety about something, I'll be like, what's the worst that's gonna happen right now? And I'll just get serious with myself and I'll be like, right now, if you're gonna freak out and if you're gonna be like, I can't do this, and you're gonna get up and you're gonna run away, what's the worst that's gonna happen? Like, what's the worst? And I'll tell myself the worst. Okay, the worst thing's gonna happen is you're gonna get yourself so worked up that you're gonna start crying, you're gonna feel nauseous, you're gonna pass out, whatever it may be. That's gonna be the worst case scenario. And I'm like, okay, well, I have control over that and I'm not gonna let myself get there. And that kind of works for me. Like, anytime I get in front of a big group of people, I'm like, I'm gonna pass out. Like, every time I'm like, oh my God, what if I just hit the floor right now? But then I'll ask myself, I'll be like, okay, what if? What if you hit the floor? You pass out, you wake back up, you're fine, you're still alive, your heart's still beating, you're still healthy. Like, I remind myself that. That for some reason helps me to cope with anxiety and to be, get over yourself, Jacqueline, get over yourself. Because I feel like people with anxiety are so in tune with themselves. And that's what I hate about it, is I hate that when I get anxiety, it's like I can't even focus on anyone around me. I'm like so selfish. It's like all about me and my anxiety, and I hate that. So I'll be like, knock it off, get out of yourself, think about something else other than you, Jacqueline. So maybe it's a little tough love. You guys are probably hoping for me to be like, you know what, I just take a bath. No, I'm like, bitch, handle it. Ideal pizza. Thin crust, extra cheese. Oh my God, this question. First time you F. First time you blank in front of your husband. I don't use that F word, not that one, because my mom raised me that that's such an ugly word. So we say like pass gas. Even that's like awkward to talk about on camera. The answer to that is I never have. That's right, you proud of your girl? Never have. It's so funny because like I haven't done that in front of my husband, and I never will. Like, he doesn't care, of course not. Like, it doesn't matter for him, but me, never, ever. But it's so funny because like anything else is totally acceptable. Like, I could have like a pussy growth, like growing on the worst part of my body, and I'm like, John, come help me with this. But that, I'm like, oh, I would never. I'm really nervous to talk about this subject, but I'm going to, because so many of you guys have asked me, and it's about my dad. I got probably 75 to 100 tweets of you guys asking if I have contact with my father, what happened to my dad, where is he at, why don't I mention him, whatever it may be. Just in general, I got questions about my dad. So someone asked if I have contact with my father, and no, I don't have contact with him at all in any way whatsoever. I don't have contact with him. My parents, like I have said, they went through a divorce, a really horrible, ugly, nasty divorce years ago. The divorce was finalized, when was it finalized? I feel like it was like 3 years ago, maybe 2.5 years ago, the divorce was finalized, and I have not talked to him since. I haven't talked to him in like 2.5 to 3 years. So that's one. I have like a couple subjects of things I've gone through in the past few years that are extremely touchy, and that's one of them. Like, I have a very, very big heart now, though, for people who go through horrible divorces, for people who, you know, are stolen from or taken from, or people who have like lost their father, whether it's to death, whether it's a divorce, no matter what it is. Like, it's giving me a really huge heart for those type of people, because I never in a million years thought that I would lose my dad. I never in a million years thought that my parents would get a divorce. I felt so bad for every one of my friends who had divorced parents. I just felt like, oh my God, that's so heartbreaking that like their parents live in two different homes now. Like, I never thought that would be me. So my parents' divorce was definitely humbling, brought me down to earth, but showed me what a queen my mom was, and showed me what a my father was. So yeah, I no longer have contact with him. None of us do. It sucks, because he was definitely my hero. Oh my God, I am not going to cry. But we were very, very close. We would all call our family the dream team, because we were all so close growing up, and I'm so thankful for that. My dad was my very best friend. We have a lot of similarities. Yeah, so extremely, extremely close. So to have him do what he did and kind of turn on us and the divorce was just, it was heartbreaking. So it sucks. It's a really sensitive subject, but it sucks, and he's no longer around. So that's that. What are your thoughts on the Lyme crime scandal? I don't want to get into this too much because I'll be sitting here talking for 45 minutes. Google the Lyme crime scandal if you guys are interested. But my thoughts on it, I made it clear on Twitter and I posted a little Snapchat video. I'll leave my Snapchat down below because I know a lot of you guys have asked what it is. No, I'm not about that life. I think that it's complete BS and I will no longer be purchasing from Lyme crime again and I'm done with them. So that's my opinion. You probably get this one a lot, but how did you and your husband meet? The first time I ever met him was through a mutual friend. He walked into my house and I saw him and there he was, standing beautifully. But I actually became like closer with him and like friends with him because he was actually the drummer in my boyfriend's band at the time. And I was a photographer and like I went to photography school later, and so I would take pictures and like band promos for the band, and my boyfriend would always be like, why are there so many pictures of John on here? And I'd be like, drums just really intrigue me. Who's your favorite YouTuber? So many people ask me this and you can't ask me to decide that. I have so many friends here on YouTube. So like, of course I'm gonna say my friends, you know? Alex Faction, PK, PK is not like in the beauty community, but he has one of my favorite channels on YouTube. He does videos that I just absolutely love him. I'll put his link down below so you guys can check out PK because you'll fall in love with him and want him to be your best friend too. You guys can't make me pick a favorite. Like there's no way, ever. Stuck on an island and you can only bring two makeup items, what would they be and why? First of all, can I trade the makeup items for food? I would do mascara and a luminizer because that way my eyes could pop a little bit and I could be real nice and glowy because we know we got that tan going on. So now I gotta highlight it, of course. What is your favorite kind of alcohol to drink? My number one just like favorite go-to drink is white wine. I like Sauvignon Blanc because it's just like citrusy and fruity and yummy. And I drink Kim Crawford, which is my favorite brand of Sauvignon Blanc. But I like wine because it kind of brings me down and mellows me out, and that's what I'm looking for. Like I love like a mojito. I like fresh things. I like things that are like fresh and berries and light, you know what I'm saying? What is your favorite part about being an adult? And if you could go back and be a kid again, would you? No, I would not go back to being a kid again, even though I absolutely loved my childhood. Things are so good when you're a kid, everything's so simple, and you don't like get the reality of life, and it's so amazing, you're so ignorant, and it's so blissful, and I love it so much. But you know, you gotta be a big kid at some point, so I wouldn't go back. But my favorite part about being an adult is my independence, because my dad was very controlling, and I couldn't do anything when I was younger. Like, I was 15 years old, and I'd go to my dad and be like, hey dad, can I go to the movies tonight with my friend? And he'd be like, no. I'd be like, oh, why not? I've done everything this week. I've done all my chores. My room is clean. I did all my school. I aced my test, and because I said so. I'm like, okay. So I guess I'll just sit here and scratch my ass for the rest of the night. Like a homeschool jungle freak. I love being an adult because I have my independence, and it's like, I can go see a movie in the middle of the day if I want to, bitch. Would you ever get a cat or another dog? I would never get a cat. I am not a cat person. I am not on this like cat lady grind whatsoever. Cats hate me. And you might think like, yeah, cats hate you, real funny. And I'm not kidding, cats hate me. All my friends who have cats, I've told them, listen, your cat's gonna hate me. And they're like, no, never, not my cat. My cat will love you. My cat loves everybody. And I walk in their house and their cat's like, and they're like, I've never seen her do that. Every cat hates me. So I don't do the whole cat thing. Another dog. John really wants another dog, and I just don't know. If you guys have two dogs, let me know if you guys love it. If you think one dog is better than two dogs. Georgie loves to play and he loves being around other dogs, but he's like so hyper so often. I'm scared he'll terrorize a puppy, so I don't know. What? I don't know. Embarrassing habit when it comes to shopping. Oh my gosh, that's such a random question. Okay, who asked me that? Kristen Franklin. That is such a random question to ask an embarrassing habit when it comes to shopping, but I actually have one. And it's when I go shopping ever since I was a little girl, when I try on an outfit that I really, really like, I start to dance. And I don't just dance, like I dance hard. You know what, I'm gonna call my mom and I'm gonna have her tell you because she'll back me up.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, Moo. I am filming right now, and you're on camera. You're on candy camera!
I'm on camera!
Okay, so I need you to back me up. I'm filming a question and answer video right now. And someone, this is the most random question ever. Do you have an embarrassing habit when it comes to shopping? And it's so funny that they asked that because I already told the camera what it was. But I'm calling you for you to back me up and tell the camera if there's something that I've done my whole life. When I try out an outfit and I'm shopping.
Well, yeah, it started when you were a little girl. When you were really little, if I had you try on something that you didn't like, you would stand in front of the mirror and you wouldn't move and you would just make like this disgusted face.
True.
But then when you put on an outfit that you loved, you would always dance. You'd always start hopping around and dancing and twirling and it's like, okay,
yes.
We have a winner.
We have a winner. Told you. All right, well, thanks, Mom. I love you.
Love you, too.
I'll see you later.
Bye-bye.
All-time favorite movie, if I had to, like, if I only could watch one movie for, like, the next month, it would be Mean Girls. That one will never die, so I guess I'll go with Mean Girls because I definitely, like, quote Mean Girls every single day of my life, and I have for 10 years. How do you usually spend your lazy days? I don't do many activities. Like a lot of people who like have a day off, they're like, oh, I went for a hike and then I grabbed a green juice and then I went on a 16-mile walk. And I'm like, are you kidding me? Love to go to the movie theater. If there's a good movie out, I go to the movies probably like twice a month with my husband or my mom or whoever, my friends. I love going to the movies. I love organizing my house. I know that that's like really, most people don't enjoy that, but I do. I find it helps my anxiety. It like clears out my mind. Like I feel like if I have a clear space, I can like, I have like peace and clarity. So I like organizing things and moving things around and stuff like that. So that's typically the kind of stuff I do on lazy days. My phone has 6%, so I have to plug it in. The biggest misconception about me would definitely have to be that I am conceited, cocky, stuck up, whatever term you want to use. I get that pretty often, you know, like I've changed. The fame has gone to my head. I'm like, what fame? What are you guys talking about? It's definitely a misconception, but I understand why people think that though. You know, I definitely do, especially like looking at my YouTube and my Instagram, the fact that I sit here, I talk about, you know, like all things beauty and how to be glamorous and makeup, you know what I'm saying? And I have designer bags and that kind of stuff. You know, it might look like I'm just like that next typical, like, but that's not me at all, at all. I don't have to defend myself. I don't have to talk about that, but that's definitely the biggest misconception that I'm stuck up in any way or whatever that might be. Because if you know me on a personal level or if you've met me, I can promise you that that's not what you think about me. Will there ever be a makeup geek in Jaclyn Hill favorites palette? Do you have any advice for boys who wear makeup but get told they shouldn't because they are of the male gender? Yes, I do have advice. Do you, boo, and screw the rest. If someone else does not appreciate the fact that you are a male who's wearing makeup, then they can go bye-bye. You don't need that in your life. You do you, screw the rest. Oh my God, this is the best question ever. Do you think Ross and Rachel were on a break? No, they were not on a break. I so do not support that. No, you were not. She was like, no, a break from us. And he just turns around and walks away and like, oh, you're on a break now? And yes, I know that he calls and Mark is there, but he didn't even give her time to explain that he goes and has sex with another girl. You were not on a break. To me, you were having a hard moment. You were having a hard time, but like the next morning you wake up, you get on the phone, you figure things out. You don't go sleep with someone else. I'm 100% team Rachel. Ross, you were not on a break. When and why did you decide to move to Florida? Well, I didn't decide. I was almost 8 years old. I was 7. I was very young. But we had to move to Florida because my dad was involved in a very horrible, severe car accident. And his legs are actually all metal on the inside. Like, he has skin on his legs, but inside, instead of bones, he has metal rods and metal plates. He was in a horrible accident. A semi hit him head on and crushed his car. He could no longer live up north because his metal rods in his legs would freeze in the wintertime and he would be in the worst pain. And it sucked so bad because he couldn't sit outside at like my brother's games anymore in the wintertime because his legs would freeze. So we had to move to a warm state. So they were like, the sunshine state, let's go. So we moved to Florida in January of 1998. I'd like to know the story behind how you had your nose broken. I thought it might be a funny story. Oh my God. So My sister's husband, now her husband, proposed to her in the entryway of our home. We came home from shopping and her husband walked out with the ring and roses and proposed. She did not know what was happening, but my family all knew it was happening. So my dad set up a video camera to record the whole thing. We all walk in the house. He opens up the door. He comes walking out. She's like, what are you doing here? Because he lived in Chicago. She lived in Florida. He gets on his knee. He opens it up and we got it all on camera. La-di-da. I, at the time, was very into videoing, very into making videos. So I accidentally recorded over a little piece of her engagement video. Teensy piece of it. I recorded over. And it was when he was on his knee in the middle proposing. I recorded over it for maybe 3 to 4 seconds, and it was actually a shot of my sister dancing. And I clicked record, and then I was like, wait, what's this tape? So I unrecorded. My sister found that out, and I was in my bedroom listening to music, dancing, and my sister comes in and punches me in the face. And when she walked in the room, my huge boombox was there, and she tripped. And so when she tripped, she like used her fist like to catch her in midair, and so she tripped and just went boom, and just right hooked me right across the face and broke my nose. So because of that, my nose is crooked. I hate it. And when I was younger, like I said, I would record myself all the time. And all of a sudden, all my videos, all I could notice was my nose was just crooked. So it sucks. And I thought about getting it fixed so many times, but I'm too scared. I'm so scared to be put under and get a nose job. Everyone that I ask, they're like, just keep it. It adds character. And I'm like, whatever. So I don't like my broken nose, but that's how it happened. And it is what it is. What's a weird habit of yours? Ooh, I have it. My husband loves this about me and I don't know why, but I grunt underneath like my, whatever it's called, like underneath my breath, I quietly grunt. It's not as bad as it used to be. I try to stop it and get it under control, but like if I feel uncomfortable in any way or if I'm watching something that's funny and I know I'm like about to laugh or whatever, it's just it's weird things like that. I kind of sit there and I go, and I kind of like do like this weird, like, kind of grunty, like moany, almost like an uncomfortable, I don't know. It's a really weird habit though, and my husband will call me out for it, and I'll be like doing it, and I never ever know I'm doing it. I don't hear it, I don't notice it, but I'll look over, my husband will just be like, looking at me, and I'm like, what? Am I grunting? And like, I know that I am, and he catches me, so that's a weird habit. What is your favorite type of donut? Okay, maple glazed. Why don't people like maple glazed? Like, I don't understand, it's like these donuts are so underrated and they're so good. Like, of course I love just like, you know, basic icing and sprinkles, but maple glazed is everything. And then of course the Krispy Kreme one, it's the one with the chocolate on top and the white icing inside, not the pudding, the yellow pudding. I can't do that, the texture freaks me out. The icing, it's like frosting on the inside and chocolate on top. Oh my God, stop. Hey babe, while you're out, would you mind picking me up a donut? So that completes this incredibly long question and answer. I don't know how long I was sitting here for. The sun is like going down. Oh no, it's not. It's just like about to rain. Let me know in the comments down below what other videos you would like to see. I know tons of you have been requesting more personal videos, which is why I was doing this one today. So I can throw in a personal video on my channel, you know, like once a month or so, do something a little bit different where I can do question and answers, or I can do like kind of videos of like my experiences with certain things in life. I've been thinking about doing a video about being bullied when I was younger and how I overcame that, and then how I became a makeup artist and, you know, got started in the industry and all that stuff. So you let me know what you guys would like to see, what you guys would like to know down below. I definitely am an open book. I will share pretty much anything with you guys as far as my personal experience. If you ask, I will answer. I just can't answer certain things that regard other people's information. You know what I'm saying? But if it regards me, my information, I have no problem sharing with you. So yeah, I hope that you guys enjoy this video. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you with a makeup tutorial very soon. Bye guys.